Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome GM's Vice Chairman, Global Product Development, Bob Lutz.
Well, listen, good morning. Thanks very much for joining us. It was a little less than a year ago that Rick Wagner, our chairman, was here as the keynote speaker at the LA Auto Show 2006. And he took the opportunity at that time to share with you the strategies and plans we have at General Motors for taking the leadership role in addressing issues surrounding the automobile and the environment. He also made some promises that managed to raise a few eyebrows, more than a few, and quite frankly kept everyone on our product development team, which I'm privileged to lead, very, very busy over the last 12 months. Well, we're here today to give you a little bit of an update, a report on the very real progress that we've made in the areas of fuel efficiency and emissions. One of Rick's key points was that there is no silver bullet. There is no single solution. There is no 100 mile per gallon carburetor or other secret solution that will solve all our energy and environmental problems overnight. And those of you who watch some of those TV reports know you cannot burn salt water. And nobody has invented a way to make cars run on pure water with a couple of little pills in it. But we can make a difference, a really big difference, by working the challenges from many different angles at the same time. So regardless of the fuel, regardless of the technology, our goal remains the same. The best possible fuel economy for whichever type of vehicle our customers choose. That's why we offer more cars that get 30 miles per gallon or better on the highway than any other automaker. And that's why we offer the most fuel-efficient full-size pickup trucks and SUVs on the market, period. And that's why we have more than 2.5 million vehicles on the road today that can run on E85 ethanol. And believe me, we've got a lot more coming. And if you want to talk hybrids, we're introducing 4 more hybrids in the U.S. this year. In fact, counting the new Saturn Green Line, we're introducing 16 hybrids in the next 4 years. That's one about every 3 months. That includes the industry's first 2-mode hybrid SUVs, where 2 electric motors are embedded in the transmission, and we can actually get electric boost at even higher highway speeds, and we're building those right now. They get up to 50% better fuel economy than their gasoline-only counterparts, and they are the most advanced vehicles of their size and type in the world today. 3 of our new hybrids, the Chevy Tahoe Hybrid, the Malibu Hybrid, the Saturn Green Line, are among the Green Car Journalist finalists for the 2008 Green Car of the Year. Now, 3 out of the 5 finalists in Green Car of the Year our GM products. That's something I think nobody would have expected a couple of years ago. So be sure to be on hand tomorrow morning when they announce the winner. We've said time and time again, we want to be part of the solution to today's society's energy issues. As a matter of energy efficiency, as a matter of national security, which is a big thing in my mind, and as a matter of environmental responsibility. We are committed. At GM, again, we believe that no one solution is right for every part of the world or even every consumer in any given market. So our approach is simple. Offer as many choices as possible to as many consumers as possible. And while we're offering these various solutions through all of our many brands, the best way to have the largest possible impact is through the broad portfolio of our high-volume global brand, Chevrolet, on its way to selling 5 million vehicles a year worldwide. And with that, we announce today that it is our strong intent to establish Chevrolet as the worldwide fuel solutions leader, the undisputed environmental and technology leader in the industry. Now, we will not achieve that by selling one highly efficient environmental icon, although, as you know, we've got one of those in the works, too. We will achieve that by striving for fuel economy leadership in all segments that Chevrolet encompasses, from the smallest passenger cars to the largest full-size pickup trucks and sport utilities. And we're already well on the way. And today, we're going even further by introducing the new Aveo 5, the Silverado hybrid pickup truck, world's first hybrid-powered full-size pickup truck with fuel economy figures that other full-size pickups can only dream about, and the full range of Chevrolet fuel solutions. Thank you.
Chevy Aveo 5. The E85, flex fuel capable Chevy Impala. The all-new Chevy Malibu Hybrid. The world's first full-size hybrid SUV, the Chevy Tahoe Hybrid. The world premiere of the most fuel-efficient full-size pickup, the Chevy Silverado Hybrid. The concept Chevy Volt. The gas-free, zero-emissions Chevy Equinox electric fuel cell. From gas-friendly to gas-free, Chevrolet.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Chevrolet General Manager Ed Pieper.
And good morning, everybody, and welcome to the widest, most innovative lineup of fuel solutions in the industry. Welcome to the new Chevrolet. Surrounding me on this stage are many choices, many different technologies, but one single purpose. Ranging from gas-friendly to gas-free, Chevrolet is determined to be the fuel solutions leader in the automotive market. This isn't just an advertising campaign, although we've been telling people about it in a big way. Instead, Chevrolet is changing at the very foundation of how we power America. Customers' needs are wide and varied, but no matter what kind of vehicle they're looking for, they want the best possible fuel economy they can find. At Chevrolet, we intend to give them exactly what they're looking for by providing many logical alternatives throughout our entire car and truck lineup. What you see here is just a sample. Let's look at some of the numbers. For people wanting fun and dependability, we're introducing the new 2009 Aveo 5 hatchback to America. This versatile small car is expected to get 35 miles per gallon on the highway, and along with great efficiency, it will be the only economy car with a 5-star safety rating and OnStar standard. Aveo 5 is just one of the 5 non-hybrid Chevy models that get 30 miles per gallon or better on the highway, according to the latest EPA ratings. There's also the Aveo sedan, rated at 34 highway, the Cobalt at 33, and both the HHR and the new Malibu are rated at 30 miles per gallon on the highway. Plus, with technologies like active fuel management, our full-size trucks and SUVs are some of the most fuel-efficient on the entire planet. Chevy also has over 2 million flex-fuel vehicles on the road right now. Not just pickups and SUVs, but sedans and vans as well. In fact, Chevy offers 7 different models able to run on E85 ethanol. And as Bob just mentioned, we're launching some exciting new hybrids. The Malibu Hybrid is rated at 24 city and 32 highway. And this affordable hybrid is value priced at just $22,790. The new two-wheel drive Tahoe Hybrid delivers a 30% improvement in overall fuel economy and a whopping 50% improvement in city driving. At 21 miles per gallon, that's the same city fuel economy as the 2008 Toyota Camry with the base 4-cylinder engine. The difference is that Tahoe seats 8, churns out 332 horsepower, and can tow up to 6,200 pounds. Soon, pickup drivers will benefit from that same combination of efficiency and capability. Next year, we'll be putting the two-mode hybrid system into the Chevy Silverado, making it the world's most fuel-efficient full-size pickup. Chevy Bolt is a whole new kind of vehicle. Plug it in overnight, then drive 40 miles without burning any gasoline. The onboard engine is only for recharging the battery, allowing you to go hundreds of miles on a single tank. And we are working furiously to make this extended range electric car a reality. And here are the best numbers of all. 0 emissions and 0 gasoline. And this is no concept, ladies and gentlemen. Our test fleet of 100 fully functional Chevy Equinox fuel cell vehicles will be distributed here in Southern California and on the East Coast in the coming months. We call it Project Driveway because we're putting these electric vehicles in the driveways of everyday folks and celebrities and handing them the keys. In fact, we have 2 of our drivers that are here with us today, Ben and Jackie Lee of Burbank, California. Stand up, you guys. Nice to have you with us. They will be among the first people to drive the Equinox fuel cell. And thanks for being here with us today. We really appreciate it. Drivers like Ben and Jackie will provide us feedback about their experiences. They'll tell us what it's like to use the vehicle in their everyday lives. This is the largest market test of fuel cell vehicles ever, and it will help define our product and our marketing plans for this exciting new technology. We've got a special announcement regarding Project Driveway, and I'd like to bring Bob Lutz back up to tell you a little bit more about it. Thanks, everybody.
Well, thanks, Ed. But before I get into the announcement, I'd like to say that the Chevy Volt and the Chevy Equinox fuel cell vehicles represent nothing less than a transformation. A transformation that affects both General Motors and the entire automotive industry. These technologies will radically alter the landscape for personal transportation for decades to come. It is as big a shift as a century ago from the horse and carriage to the horse-less carriage. So it makes sense then, as we step into this future world of transportation, that we partner with an organization that is well known for bringing the future into the present. So, I'm glad to announce that the Walt Disney Company will be taking 10 of the Project Driveway cars to use as shuttles on Disney properties here in California. Bob Iger, the president and chief executive officer of Walt Disney Company, has sent along a short message that we'd like to share with you.
Good morning, everyone. Hello, Bob. I'm sorry I couldn't be with you personally this morning. The LA Auto Show is always a great event, and we're very excited about the launch of Project Driveway, the first major market test of hydrogen fuel cell vehicles. It's fitting that the Walt Disney Company is taking part in this important and historic experiment. Walt himself was always dreaming about what the future would bring, and he introduced cutting-edge technologies to the art of movie making and into our theme parks. He was also a strong proponent of environmental conservation, a legacy that we are proud to uphold at Disney today. For the last 25 years, GM and Disney have had a great working relationship, and we're excited that GM has chosen Disney to be its partner for Project Driveway. When GM's zero-emission vehicles arrive in Burbank and New York, I'm sure everyone at Disney will be lining up to take them for a spin, including me. We applaud GM for its efforts to make fuel cell vehicles an effective alternative to cars powered by petroleum. This is a critically important effort and certainly a very timely one. We're delighted to be taking part in Project Driveway and hope to contribute to its success. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you, Bob. This is a partnership between two of the most forward-looking companies in America, and we're glad that Disney could join us in this very important project. A couple of our friends from Disney Company are with us today. They are seated in the front row. We have Lawrence Aldridge, Disney Senior Vice President for Corporate Alliances, and Chris McNamara, Vice President of Corporate Environmental Policy. Thank you both for joining us here today. We really appreciate it. Lawrence and Chris will be around after the program to answer your questions about Disney's involvement in Project Driveway. At General Motors, a passion for design and advanced technology is in our DNA. So while our engineers and technicians have been working overtime on all of our different fuel solutions, our 11 global design studios have been very busy pushing the envelope on automotive design. Now, three global car concepts that have received a lot of attention since their debut last spring at the New York Automobile Show are the Chevy Beat, the Groove, and the Trax. These highly efficient small cars, planned for about 50 miles per gallon highway, were developed by our design studio in Bukyong, South Korea, where obviously they have a lot of experience in designing very small cars. Now, so far, as you'll recall, at the New York show, we said that we were going to enable people to vote for the concept of their choice on the internet. Nearly 1.9 million people in North America, South America, Europe, and Asia have voted online for their favorite of the three. Now, here are two of the most popular Chevy city car concepts, Beat and Groove. Okay, with over 713,000 votes, the Chevy Groove over here on my right is running a close second in our online voting. The clear leader, however, is the Chevy Beat, with more than 875,000 votes so far. And I'm glad to announce that the Chevy Beat gets our vote too, because that was the one we intended to do in the first place. And so we're really glad it won. Can't tell you how many GM folks had to vote to put it over the top. No. Only kidding. That's not even in the script, all right? But we will be building a car based on the Beat in the very near future at our Korean production facilities. It just, as I said, happens to be the one that we wanted to have win from the beginning. So it's always great that the democratic process reinforces what you intended to do top-down anyway. But hey, keep those votes coming in, all right? Who knows? Who knows? We might just decide to do that and that, because there's a huge fan base for that. Either way, it's yet another addition to Chevrolet's broad portfolio of fuel solutions for customers to choose from. So with that, thanks to all of you for joining us here today. And now, please come up here, take a closer look at all that Chevrolet has to offer. Ed Pieper will be joining me on stage, as well as other General Motors experts in the audience. Be happy to answer your questions. Thank